Hi, I'm glad to see you. Today we make another painting, so prepare your colors, brushes, and ready to go. What I have for you today is black canvas covered up with a mixture of phthalo blue and black, to the bluish side. Now we will use just black, phthalo blue, and white. And if you really don't know, all colors will be in the description below, so let's start it. First, we start with a small amount of titanium white. Very small, this is too much. Now, we will decide where our moon will be, the brightest spot in the sky. So for me it will be here. Maybe I decided, maybe I have to put here more of a mixture. Always keep eye on that, because color must slick on the canvas. Let's put more white around here. Now slowly blend this. Now, if you think that your canvas is too dry, just add more of your mixture. You need to show if something goes wrong what to do. Just apply another coat. That easy. In the worst scenario, you can scrub all the paint out. And start over. These paints are very forgiving. I usually don't show this step, but okay. Now let's continue. From center to out. Crisscross, like this. Hmm. Now here had to be less color than here, because main source have more white than the other part of the sky. Blend this a little bit. In this step, we don't very much. Now, another brush, very dry. He goes from center to all sky. If you notice, this is a used canvas. I just covered up with black, and before that I scraped off all the paint. It's very hard to get to any resources right now. But despite that, we are good. Now we can blend this to the smoothest transition that we want. Now, let's do a moon. There's a flat brush, small. You'll put a little bit of white and you start doing a circle. Very small circle. It'll get bigger and bigger. Okay. I'll try to remove much as you can, the white. And we'll do this. The color underneath will mix it. We'll get to right color proportion automatically. Now, this will be a little bit drastic, but Oh. Don't worry about it. Just have to remove this color. Now we can use our darker color for a base to blend this in. That's perfect. Okay. Now the clouds. We will use our base. And we prepare gray. Gray is just black and a bunch of white. More white. You put into this mixture, more gray it becomes. I learned one thing: if you put your base color into all the colors here, except of white, maybe, to be nice and clean and scenic. So now, this brush has to be like a knife, very sharp. Now let's put a cloud right here. Like that. Maybe another one right here. And here, and here, maybe one here on the top, maybe one right here. Reload your brush. Step back to look at. And keep adding clouds to the point when you are satisfied. You can do big fluffy clouds or these. Maybe here will be a big one. And maybe here too. Now we have a touch of white or a gray, maybe gray more. Yeah, gray, black. Now here's a touch of a black, with a touch of a base color. A little bit less. And now we start putting our shadows to clouds. Maybe a little bit more black. Okay. Your shadows have to be out of a light source, so not on this side, but the other side. Now I clean my brush, a little touch of a gray, and now I will blend these clouds a little bit. Just like that. Now it comes more fun part. A little gray or what? No, white to our brush that will become gray. Now we put highlights. This really puts a nice vibe to it. Okay. Now our clouds are done. You see how messy is our palette, so we will clean this up. Excuse me. Okay. Now let's do a mountain. So we will use base color with a touch of this gray. Add a little roll of the paint. Now let's decide where our mountain will go. So for me, this will start right here. Here comes the big one. Now we will scrape this paint here. From these edges, I'll put it right here. Maybe this cool goes like this, just off the edges. Okay. Now we'll clean our palette knife. I will try it next we go to the store and buy some canvases. I hope they will be open. Let's use I don't know, this brush we used before. It doesn't matter really. And I will pull this color out like this under this angle. We will do this from peaks to bottom. So now let's clean this place up. Now I'm just cleaning my palette very quick. Okay. Now we use white, touch of a phthalo blue. Oh, very nice. And gray. Even more white. Okay, control and paint again. And now when you start, it will look, might be ugly, but when you will work and work, it eventually goes the insane shapes. So let's start right here. Barely touching. And just go like that. Don't work fast. Give it a time. Now, this is just a basic layout right here. This could easily change. Don't worry to experimenting. Because with that we learn. Maybe touch a clear white. Try it. Now we will put a touch of white right here. And here. Maybe we'll connect these two sides. No. Let's just extend this white. Okay. Now let's pull that color back and forth very slowly. Okay. Now we go up. And we go back to white. Then just extend this. Just a bit more here. Okay. Now gently lift upward. Very gently. Okay. So our mountain is done. Now we have to do hills. That sounds easy. And it is easy. With a bunch of titanium white from both sides. Now, let's you know what? I changed my mind. Let's do the trees first. The trees, I believe, is phthalo blue. It's very nice and strong color. I don't like much blue, but it's very nice. Now, touch of a white into it. A little bit of black, base color, now it's completely different color, that easy. Let's do a check if this sits here, very sharp by the way. Oh, a little bit more of a dark. Now just by tapping the edge, just do a forest. Now the brushing continue. We'll continue with this forest somewhere. This side, and we'll stop around here. We'll extend these. Smaller trees, more far of a distance. Try to not overdo it. And if you did that, don't worry. Start over and over and over. Until you know perfectly what you're doing. Now you would just basically do a covering, a transition between this mountain and this black space. Sorry if you hear any voice in background. You know, sometimes I forget a lot of small details in everyday life. Now I forget something that is really significant for this painting. And I forgot to put shadows here. Don't worry, we'll put that later. Okay. Now clean your palette knife. Clean even the edges. Now, oops. Let's do shadow color now. I will use this or black base with some of a tree color. Yeah, this could work. Maybe touch of white, maybe more. Don't blend it too much. Small little paint, as always. And this time I loaded both sides of my brush, palette knife, this and this. so we can work on details too. Now let's shadows color right there. You can do this basically with a smaller side, but that is a waste of time. And if you want details, okay. Okay, I will use the smaller one. Next time, I hope I will do a bright painting. Nice and day. Sunny, cloudy painting. I really like that. But I like even a night. It's not something that I hate or, but it is better. If I could sleep throughout the day, that would be an absolute win for me. But really, I can't. Okay, there's shadows on the place. Now let's fill this a little bit. Now let's continue with our tree line. Now with this brush full of white, we do something like this. A small hill. For the basic concept right there. We can tint it with our oil. This is a linseed oil. Very small drop to white. Very small. Let's use more white and extend this angle. Now at this point I'm just adding the color here, so it will not will be a bunch of spots with blank canvas. Now we soften this edge. Like so. Now I will... Whoa, that's too much of white. Just small... right here. Nothing that big. Okay. Now let's blend this. Let's do another round of trees. Or just we add a little bit more of an extension here. Now we blend this bottom of these trees right into the hill. I just extend a few little ones. Okay. Oh. Now other trees had to be a little bit more brighter, so I'll use titanium white, phthalo blue. And touch it with black. Let's check if this, or maybe more black. Always check if your colors are really in sync. Let's try this. Okay. That goes pretty well. Now that was just a test. And we'll use this pretty round brush. And just load a bunch of that color there. too much weight. Now pull down this color out, straight down. You pull that down very flat. And now when the brush is touch of white, we'll pull this straight through. Now we go across. You can put a little bit of oil on our brush. Clean it up. I'm going to hide this. Now we will use this brush, but we'll clean it up in paper towel. We'll grab a bunch of white. Now we start doing a waterline with some fields right there. Try to keep your brush straight. More like a knife. I'll put some depth to it. More white right there. Now we'll just this back to. Okay. Clean it small brush again. Load there. A little bit of black and blue. I'll just try to put there. Smaller trees. We can do the same on this side too. Just enjoy what you're doing. It all matters. Keep rolling your brush. This is very important. Your colors will don't blend to each other. Okay. Now you go across, and that easy reflection. That easy. Oops. Now, I made this brush. This is just a flat one, but like a fan brush. Oops. And with that, we'll do one big tree, or maybe two. Or maybe watch as we want to. So now we will load a bunch of black on both sides. Phthalo blue, more phthalo blue. Touch of white into it. Load two sides, both, and load this too. And with this one, we do a peak right there. Now let's work with this. Start slowly from a corner. Now we are using entire brush. How interesting. Look, here is unfinished part. Look what we do. cover this. Maybe here we'll have a friend. Smaller one. And the same. Your corner. Slowly tap. You know what? I just do a very small one right here. Very small. You can fill this part with a paint roller. Unless you don't want details, but it doesn't matter. Now one part we have done, let's do another. Now I'm just reloading my brush. I hope you do same thing. Now we put one right there. Let's do him a small friend. Okay. More black there. Oh, one here is here. Okay, it's out. I just put more black there. Now same brush, but just a little bit of white on it. Now I go to highlights. And overdo it. And put your highlights randomly. Try to put it on the hanging leaves more. Now we need to do one thing. You see how these trees are reflected? That's good. But we don't have to forget on everything and forget on clouds. It will be funny. So now I will. Oh, and more dark. Maybe a touch of a more black. It'll be perfect. Maybe one goes right here. Okay. Last thing would be, not the last thing, but we will do a bunch of white. We do a bush. Right one here. Now let's do the details. One easy trick. This is a knife. Very old one. No. Green decaying shims over branches. Don't trade randomly. Just how like a branch go. Now I decided to put a little bit of white highlights to her clouds. Just indication. Okay, now we have done. So this is a finished piece. I hope you enjoy all the fun parts in this technique. It's very easy. And see you soon. Goodbye.